Texas could finish 12-9.
That's right. Oh, here we go.
Ah, here we go.
Semenko. And look at Fadil sitting right there waiting to see what happens.
Everybody picks up a man.
These are the tough guys.
Semenko trying to get a copy.
Yeah. Semenko and Tim Hunter. And kind of interesting, Jimmy, we were talking and said, you know, if this game ever does get a 3 or 4 goal lead for one team, this is what might happen. And sure enough, seconds after the Oilers go up by three, it all breaks loose. You got Fadil and McSorley together. Hunter and Semenko are already in the middle of a fight. Big Terry Johnson out there for Calgary.
Fadil and McSorley trying to decide who's going to lead.
That's right. They're just waiting. They are just waiting to try to get the upper hand. These guys, when they fight, they try to grab each other by the arms to prevent the other guy from punching, almost a defensive style, and whoever gets the hand loose first will get the first lick in.
Hunter and Semenko didn't really get loose to get at each other.
It looks to me like there's a pile of blood down behind the net, too. And I think it's on Tim Hunter's face by the look of it. There's a melee down there between Huddy, Coffey, Johnson, Bozak, and I can't tell who the other Flame is.
This whole series has been a cauldron of water waiting to boil over, and it finally has, with a 3-goal lead, finally for one team, and it being the Edmonton Oilers, the tough guys get on the ice and mix it up. McSorley and Fadil are wearing each other out.
The reason they haven't got down there to separate him is that the two linesmen are just escorting Semenko and Hunter to their benches and probably the dressing rooms. And
well, with a 3-goal difference in the game.
It's Sheehy, number 5, is the 5th Calgary player. Huddy and Coffey.
What do you bet that with a 3-goal difference in this game and this now happening, Bob Myers kicks a few guys right out of the game. Misconduct to be handled.
I think Kevin McClellan, I think 24, is in that big pileup. They cannot get those four apart because they don't want to let each other go. It's an opportunity they can get some wax in. They dance around now.
McSorley and Fadil have been around the ballroom twice.
Well, they've decided to keep it cool, which is good.
Terry Johnson in there as well, number 6 for Calgary. He's a pretty tough hombre.
Well, there's some respect on both sides between McSorley and Fadil. Respect for the other guy. And finally, they seem to have them cooled down. So we'll take a break.